In this lecture, we are going to set up our development environment for Linux with all the tools that are required to develop smart contracts for Ethereum. We're not going to describe all of them, but focus on those that are widely used by the community. By the way, this lecture is specifically for Linux. If you are running on Windows or macOS, there are dedicated lectures for that. So our toolbox will be composed of the following tools: geth, Ganache, truffle, and Atom. Let's start with geth. Geth, or Go Ethereum, is the command line interface that allows you to run and operate a full Ethereum node. Geth is implemented in Go and allows you to mine blocks, to generate ether, to deploy and interact with smart contracts, to transfer funds, to inspect block history, to create accounts, and so on and so forth. Geth can be used to connect to the public Ethereum network, also called mainnet, or to create your own private network for development purposes, which we will demonstrate later in this course. The benefit of using geth in your development process is to let you fully test your application before deploying it to the mainnet. The exact procedure to install geth might depend on your exact Linux distribution. More information is available at the following location. By the way, this link and all the other links that we mention in this video and all the other videos will be in the resources of each lecture. On Ubuntu, which is the distribution we are using here, now in the terminal, I can use the following commands to install everything. So first of all, sudo apt install software properties common. Okay, so I already have the latest version installed. That's good. Now I need to add the repository for Ethereum. So add -apt-repository-y ppa:ethereum-ethereum. Okay, and now I can do sudo apt update to update the repositories. And last but not least, sudo apt install Ethereum. I confirm the changes. And once those commands completed successfully, you can check the version that is installed by running geth version. And here you can see I have 1.7.3 stable, which is the latest version at the time of this recording. Okay, so geth is installed now. The second tool that we'll install is Ganache. Now, Ganache is an Ethereum blockchain emulator that you can use for development purposes. Ganache can be seen as a replacement for TestRPC, which we used in previous versions of this course. The strength of Ganache is its UI that allows you to inspect blocks and transactions in a more user-friendly way. Compared to geth, Ganache is an in-memory Ethereum node that runs faster and provides all the visual components you need to test your contracts locally before deploying them to a real Ethereum implementation. To install Ganache, we can go to the browser, to truffleframework.com/Ganache. And here it will detect that I'm on Linux and offer to download the Linux package. So here this button made me download an app image package. So I'm just going to show it in folder, right click it, properties, permissions, allow executing file as a program. So I'm just making this file executable. And now I can double click it. Would you like to integrate Ganache with your system? Yes, please. And then it starts Ganache. So first of all, I will accept analytics. And this is the main interface for Ganache. Let me close everything around it so that we can see more clearly. Okay. So let's quickly review the main features of Ganache. When you start Ganache, it starts a new Ethereum node in memory on network identifier 5777, which we can see here in this part of the screen. And it also creates 10 accounts and puts 100 ethers on each account. Now, contrary to what happened with TestRPC, Ganache always creates the same accounts and uses the same mnemonic. So it's deterministic, which is very practical when we will need to import all those accounts later on in MetaMask. So the first screen you see is the accounts view. And here at the top of the screen, you can see the current block, which is the number of the last block mined by the node. You can see the gas price, which is the minimum gas price this node requires on transactions in order to mine them. The gas limit is the maximum gas this node is willing to accept per block. The network identifier you can see here. RPC server corresponds to the host and port of the RPC endpoint that this node is listening to. And the mining status is also important because by default, this fake node only mines a new block when it receives a new transaction, which is completely different from what a real node would do, since a normal node would mine a new block at regular intervals, whether there are pending transactions or not. We'll come back to that later. You can disable auto-mining, come back to more normal behavior, and even set a mining block time in the settings. We'll see that in a moment. And here we also have the mnemonic, which is the seed words that are used to generate the wallet of the 10 accounts in a deterministic way. Then you can see a list of the 10 accounts generated by Ganache with the following information. The wallet address of the account, its balance in Ether with only two decimals, the number of transactions already sent by this account since the node started, the index of the account in the list of accounts, and the private key button that makes it possible for you to see the private key for each account, which will be very practical when we import the accounts in MetaMask. The second tab is the blocks tab, and it shows a list of all the blocks mined by this node. And for now, when we launch, there's only one block, the Genesis block, and it doesn't contain any transaction. We also have the transactions tab, where we will be able to see a list of transactions. For now, there is none. And in the logs tab, we can see the console output for the running node. We also have a search field where we can search blocks and transactions by numbers and hashes. And finally, we have the settings button where we can customize the configuration of Ganache. So we can change the host name, the port number, and the network identifier. We'll actually do that a lot later on. We can also deactivate auto mining and set a mining block time. In our case, we'll leave auto mining on. We can also customize the number of accounts that are generated when Ganache starts and change the mnemonic. Here we'll leave it as default. In the chain part, we can change the gas limit and the gas price. And in advanced, we can enable or disable Google Analytics. Remember that every time you change something in the settings, you need to save and restart. Here we'll just cancel and we'll leave Ganache. The next things we need to install are Node.js and NPM. Now, Node.js is a server-side JavaScript platform to create applications that will interact with our Ethereum node. When we install Node.js, we also install Node Package Manager, or NPM, that is required to set up most of the tools and libraries required to develop for Ethereum. To check if Node.js and NPM are already installed on your machine, you can use the following command in the terminal, node-v, and npm-v. Here, I don't have any version already installed. If you have already Node.js or NPM, check that your Node.js is at least version 8 and NPM is at least version 5. Otherwise, you will need to upgrade them or remove your current installation and install Node.js again from scratch. The procedure to do that might depend on your exact Linux distribution and the version of Node.js that's already installed. Google is your best friend here. If Node.js is not already installed on your system, Node.js can be installed in different ways. We are going to follow the procedure specified on the Node.js website. So we can go to the browser and open nodejs.org, go to downloads, and at the bottom we can see installing Node.js via package manager. I'm going to go there and then click on whatever Linux distribution we're using. And here we are using a Debian and Ubuntu-based Linux distribution. So this procedure will use curl, and I'm not sure that it's already installed, so I'm going back to the terminal and run sudo apt install curl. Okay, so now curl is installed. I can go back to the website and copy the command that is most adapted. In our case, we want to install Node.js 9. So I will copy this command. And this will simply add the repository to apt. Okay, now that is there, I can run sudo apt install minus y node.js. Now, if you can see on the website, they also recommend to install the build tools that are going to be important to install certain NPM packages. So I'll also copy that and run it in our terminal. And I already have the latest version, which is good. So now that this is done, if I type node minus v, I should see the latest version, and npm dash v should show me the 5.5.1 version. Next thing we need to set up is truffle 4. Now, to compile, test, and deploy your smart contracts, you will need a build framework that will increase your development velocity compared to doing it manually. And we will demonstrate that fact later in this course. In this context, we are going to use truffle 4 as opposed to truffle 3 that we used in previous versions of this course. And you can find more information about it on truffleframework.com. truffleframework.com. Actually, as you can see, it's installed as an NPM package. So we can go back to the terminal and run NPM. So the first thing we need to do is to uninstall previous versions of Truffle. This is important. If you already have Truffle version 3 or below, you definitely need to uninstall them first. So to do that, you run npm uninstall dash g truffle. And once this is done, we use npm install dash g, but we won't install just the latest version of Truffle. We will focus on 4.04. This is to avoid any breaking change in newer versions that might not work with this course content. So here I can see that I have missing write access to, and that's normal because I completely forgot that on Linux, we need to run these commands with sudo. And now that it is done, I can run truffle version to check that 4.04 is installed and version 0.4.18 of the Solidity compiler is also set up. The last step of this lecture is to install a text editor that we will use to edit our smart contracts and other text files. At this point in time, there's no real Ethereum IDE. You can find some plugins for IntelliJ, WebStorm, or even Microsoft Visual Studio Code, but not a full IDE covering all the development chain. But that's okay, because we have some interesting free text editors that are good enough for what we want to show here. In this course, we chose to use Atom, because it's freely available for Mac, Windows, and Linux. But of course, you're free to use the one that you are more familiar with. To install Atom, we can go to the GitHub repository, github.com/atom/atom. Again, the link will be in the resources. And then we can go to releases. And there you can choose not the beta package, but the latest stable release. So here it would be 1.23.2. If you are on Ubuntu or a Debian distribution, which is our case, you can also install it from the terminal. Then I can run sudo apt update. And finally, sudo apt install Atom. So here normally we installed Atom and APM as well, which is the Atom package manager. We can actually start Atom to make sure that the environment is initialized. And finally, we can run APM install language Ethereum to install the plugin in Atom to support the Solidity language, which we will use to write our smart contracts later on. So at this stage, we have all the tools that we need to start the development of our smart contracts on Linux. In the next lecture, we'll show you how to create, set up, and start your own private Ethereum node.